Now, the next one. What are opposite rays? Opposite rays are two rays which begin from the same origin and extend in opposite directions. And extend in opposite directions. So this we have to remember. One, the opposite rays, we will be having two rays. If one is along the right, the other ray should be along the left. And they should start from the same common point or the same origin. Now, let us start with question 5. Practice set 1.2, question 5. And we can see here the question. Write the name of the opposite ray of ray RP. Children, see, this is the origin. This is the ray RP. If I cover this side, this is the ray RP. And RP is along the right hand side. RP is along the right hand side. And the origin of the ray RP is R. The origin of ray RP is R. So whatever answer we are going to write, both are going to be the rays only. So both are going to be the rays only. Correct? Both are going to be rays. But they are opposite rays. So starting from this origin towards the left, starting from the point R, that is the origin towards the left, we have ray RS, we have ray RS, and we have ray RT, and we have ray RT. So ray RS and ray RT, ray RS and ray RT are the opposite rays of ray RP. First, you need to check the direction of RP. RP is along the right hand side. So we will take those rays which are to the left hand side of RP but beginning with R, but starting with R or beginning with R. Now the next question, we have taken the fifth question. The first is there and then we are making use of the fifth and the sixth question because these three sums are alike. Now, write the pair of opposite rays with common endpoint R. So they have already told us, they have stated we have to write the names of those rays which begin from R. So to the right we have ray RP, and if we have two units, we have ray RQ. So along the right hand side only we have two rays which are starting from R. So that is ray RP and ray RQ and ray RQ. Then along the right side we have ray RS and then we have ray RT. Now this I have told you. Now children, this I have told you about the four rays which are beginning from the origin R. But if you look carefully, the names of the rays we have studied now. But what kind of ray they should be? They should be opposite. So RP is along the right hand side. So the opposite ray of RP can be RS. It can also be RT. So let me write ray RP and ray RP and ray RS and ray RS. So this is the first answer. And let us write one more. Let us write ray RQ, ray RQ, which is again to the right. So the other ray should be on the left hand side. So ray RQ and ray RT and ray RT. Okay. Now write any two rays with common endpoint S. So this time we have to write those rays which are beginning from point S. So S, to the right we have SR, we also have SP, we also have SQ, correct? And on the left hand side we have ray ST. Correct, children? There are so many rays. So let us write. Let me just repeat once again. Write any two rays with common endpoint S. First, let us see all the names starting from S. Here they have not mentioned opposite or anything. Here they have not mentioned the word opposite. So you have to write the names of those rays that begin with S. So the options are SR or SP or SQ or ST. So let us write down the name of any two, because they have asked any two, the names of any two rays. So ray SR and ray ST and ray ST. Now look here, children, when such a questions are given, you can have more than one answer. Sometimes the answer is fixed, and in some cases, like you have seen here, we are getting total four names, but out of that we are writing only two. We are writing only two. Here also total four answers are possible, but we have written only two answers. Here also we have written only two answers. Okay, so more than one answer, multiple answers are possible when we consider those questions which are of this type, Now you can see, children, we have solution of homework 7, wherein you were asked to find whether segment DE and AB are congruent and BE and AD are congruent. So when we are working out the sum, we get a length of DE as 16 and we get length of AB as 8. So 16 and 8 are not the same. Therefore, we write length DE not equal to length AB. So the segments DE and segment AB are not congruent. The third sum which was given for homework. Children, there you are asked to find whether segment BE and AD are congruent. Now, when we found the length of BE, we get answer as 4. And when we found the length of AD, there also we got the answer as 4. So because length BE is equal to length AD, so segment BE and segment AD are congruent. Okay? Yeah.